gems. Welcome back to Katie's Corner. Thank you so much for joining us again in Katie's Corner. We have a bunch of goodies for you today, and we're focusing on Acting 101. Acting to me is exciting. It's a full expression. I love the classics like Charlie Chaplin, the silent film era, where you are able to see so much expression and movements through the film and the lens, but without saying a word. That's just a moment of freedom and expression. I think it's so cool. So I love acting so much. It's funny because I think I was just born with it. I felt like I was just a born actor. We're all actors. Everything in life is about storytelling, and actors tell other people's stories, right? So everything's moment to moment within a story and made up of experiences. That's what acting is. So it's amazing when an individual can look at a script, a story, a scenario, circumstance, situation, and they see, okay, this is what's happening, and the human being has their approach to it based on their real life experiences or something that they saw, and then they incorporate it and make it their own, and you put it into the scene and you put it into the work. So there's no right or wrong. In acting, there's no right or wrong. It's you can only act from your authentic self and from your own experiences. So when I think about myself as an actor, a performer, I always remember this video I saw of myself in diapers holding this long broomstick, just singing, you know, singing along to music. And so that's more of like a singer or like, you know, a vocalist. But I think they go hand in hand with one another because I was performing, I was entertaining. And that's one of my first childhood memories. I'm just in diapers with little blonde bangs with the long broomstick and just like singing and smiling and just being free. So it doesn't matter if you're introverted or extroverted. You don't always need an outgoing personality to be an actor. There are a lot of actors who are very shy, who, you know, do amazing work on camera, but then they're just very to themselves. So there are different ways to see if, you know, acting could be for you. So maybe if you're more like me in a sense, you'll like the, you know, the comedies or the Broadway or the big movie TV kind of shows, you know, but I also like the, you know, serious acting roles. So maybe then you would wanna read some books and just get some more information to see if you like the methodologies of the craft, and everything starts with the backbone. So I would definitely say watch some TV shows and watch films and identify and say, hey, I like this tone. I like the vibe. I like the moral of these kind of stories. I'm personally not into horror stories. I get very scared. I didn't grow up watching scary movies. Like, I mean, I saw Freddy and I saw Jason, like the classics, but it was very, very scary to watch those. And so, yeah, there's, you know, see what kind of things you like watching. And then if you like watching it, maybe you would like playing in that kind of role or in that kind of fantasy and story. You know, there's like sci-fi and fantasy, and there's all different sorts of kinds of roles that you can play. You want to seek a mentor, a coach, someone who has experience within the industry that you want to be a part of. So you can ask them questions and get good answers. So you're led in the right direction. So you can, you know, reflect and start your journey to see what interests you, what doesn't, and then decide which class you want to take. I would definitely Google and look up acting classes. You can always reach out to me and ask me if I know them. You could also contact the local agencies in your area and say, hey, you know, I'm not with your agency and I'm really interested in getting involved in acting. So I was wondering, do you have a list of people you could recommend to me so I'm, you know, taking some good classes? You know, so they could be kind, a local agency that could give you information. So after you've done the research and you identified what makes you tick from within as an actor, and you've been in some local plays and or you've taken some classes, maybe had some one-on-one professional coaching, read some books, then I would suggest putting together a resume. So you want to look at my professional resume, and there's an industry standard of how resumes should look. So don't put your phone number on there. Don't put your address on there. There's a certain format to it. So it's, you know, TV, film, theater, you know, education is at the bottom, and then special skill sets. If you have representation, great, put your representation on there. At this point, you wouldn't be equity or union, so you can put an email for people to contact you. Everything is digital nowadays, which is great for you, so it's more cost effective. Before, you would, you know, pay for headshots, hair, makeup, then pay for a retoucher and get them printed and have all these headshots, and then gosh, 6 months later, you have to do the same cycle, because as a human being, all you have is your resume and your headshot, and the seasons change. So you have to have a spring headshot, a summer headshot, a winter headshot. And, you know, sometimes people cut or dye their hair, or, you know, you might be at an age where 6 months from now you look like a completely different person. So you, as a professional actor, you always need to have a headshot. The number one thing is having great headshots. And another thing I want to share with you, a lot of people get so worked up and worried about having the perfect headshot, so they identify with the perfect headshot with spending top dollar with the top people. And let me tell you something, I spent top dollar with the top people and they still do not get me and capture my authentic self. So quality over quantity is important. Quality over the price is really important. And now with technology, so many people are photographers and so many people can do things with the lighting and post-production to still have a great photo of you without the whole bells and whistles of going into this massive studio and having all the massive lights and being intimidated by all the electronics. So you can definitely contact me and I can give you referrals in your local town. If we're in the same town, I'm a photographer, I could even shoot you. So we can talk and keep the conversation going. Someone didn't tell me that at a very young age for a long time. And I felt so by myself, and I felt so much pressure, and I put so much pressure on me to have like the perfect headshot with like my hair and my makeup. And like, seriously, when you're doing a photo shoot with a photographer, not only are you paying for them, but you're paying another fee for hair and another fee for makeup. For guys, it's less because they have less hair and less makeup. But still, it's like when you're having someone who doesn't know you do your makeup, then it's like sometimes they make you look like it's not you. And then you're getting these headshots and you're looking like a clown, or you're looking like, I don't know, it's just like off. So it's very, very particular and very important to spend your time and study and not be taking advantage of. Okay, so the next step would be when you feel you're ready and talk to your coach and acting teachers, whoever you're studying with at a local theater, and you know, you want to have the conversation, hey, I want to put something on camera, a comedic scene and a dramatic scene. You want to have one of each. And you want to pick a scene from a play or from your favorite movie or something that you've been working on. When you're ready to do that, you can have them record you and you have a comedy scene and a dramatic scene, and then you have it together on a reel with a black slate of your name, and you can submit that to local agencies to have representation as a non-union actor, because there's union and non-union, and so you can take your headshot, your resume, and your reel, and you can say, hey, here's my cover letter and my acting chops, and you submit it to agencies, and you have them look at it, give you feedback, and then ask them for a meeting to come in because you want to be represented by them. One of my favorite books is called Respect for Acting. It's by Uta Hagen. You can read it, you can listen to it on audio, it's amazing. And guess what? I am going to put in the bottom a list of books that are my favorite go-to acting books to help you get started. Isn't that so cool? I'll also have some other links on there that you can check out, and that will help you on your way and on your new journey for acting. And if you have any questions, you can reach out to me and let me know what you think, and I'm here for you. And just so you know, it's a process, and it's a long process. It's a journey. It's a life journey. So if someone who wants to get into acting and they're thinking it's a wham, bam, thank you, ma'am, or like a quick kind of fix, it's not for you. It's not what it is. It's the fantasy. It's the illusion. I don't want to burst the bubble or anything like that. But I mean, there are some people, they say, who have overnight successes, or they book their first audition, you know, like, and those things could happen. There's beginner's luck. But even if you like book your first show, you're still booking your first show or your first job, and you're off to the races for a journey. For example, I think Ashton Kutcher, that 70s show, I think he was like a model and it was his first acting audition and he booked the role. I don't know the whole entire detail of the stories. He would know better than I would, but look at him since that 70s show. If you look at his career and his choices and his partnerships and the movies he's gone on to be in, and you know, maybe he's producing films. So, and then look at where he's at and what he's doing now. So everyone has a journey. Like, he's not only an actor, he's involved in different areas, and now he has a family, and it's a journey that keeps on going and growing. And it's all about community and building amazing relationships and planting seeds. So like your first coach or your first acting class and your, you know, the community that you build, you can plant seeds to always remain friends with them, because you never know, in like 3 years, 5 years, 10 years, they may be on shows hiring you, or maybe you'll say, oh, I thought I was really interested in acting, but now you're a producer or an actor and you're on the other side of the camera, or you're both, like I am, on both sides of the camera, being an actor but also being a producer of projects. Leave in the comments below things you've learned. Share with a friend. If you know someone who wants to get into acting, please share this information with them. Again, I'm here for you. Email me, leave comments, subscribe, like, share the content, spread the love, keep positivity and education at the forefront, keep your morals and your values. You know, it's a dream. Don't sell your dream for desperation and for a chance to be a part of something that maybe you're not sure about. Take your time, reach out to people, ask the questions if you don't know. You know, if you're scared or intimidated, know that that's okay as well. It's a part of the unknown process and us being human beings. So I'm so happy to be here and share information with you. And I'll see you next time in Katie's Corner.